know what power love has down here. But I have heard that he has some, for he brought you, Hades, together with Persephone. That is true, that passion moved you once. Then listen to me. I tried to master this grief, and I can't. I understand we all come here in the end. My bride, Eurydice, will soon enough be yours in the ripeness of her years. I'm asking for a loan, not a gift. If you deny me, one thing is certain. I want you to keep me here as well.
As he spoke, the pale phantoms began to weep. Tantalus was no longer thirsty, and Sisyphus sat on his rock to listen.
Orpheus, turn around! Eurydice! Your song has moved me, Orpheus. And you may have her on one condition. As you ascend and leave this place, she will not walk beside you, but she will be following. You must not, until you pass our gates, turn around to look at her. If you look at her before you reach the sunlight, she is mine forever.
I understand.
Remember, hesitation or doubt, and our gift must be returned. A simple enough condition.
It ought to have been. He led the way, ascending the sloping path through the murk.
She has to be behind me. Said to myself, she has to be behind me. Said it aloud and heard it fade away. She has to be behind me. But her steps were ominously soft. If only I could turn around, just once. A long way we had traveled, almost all the way. But you know what happens. Concerned for her, not quite believing that it wasn't just a cruel delusion, a dream, or a mirage. I turn.
I was once so loved that from one lyre a whole world of lament arose, in which all of nature reappeared. Forest and valley, road and village, field and stream and animal, and that around this lament world, even as around the other earth, a sun revolved, and a silent star-filled heaven, a lament heaven, with its own disfigured stars. So greatly was I loved. But now I was deep within myself and could not see the man in front of me or the path ascending steeply into life. So deep within myself, death fulfilled me beyond fulfillment. I was filled with death, which was so new that I could not understand that it had happened. I was no longer that woman with brown eyes that echoed through the poet's songs. No longer the wide couch's scent and island, and that man's property, no longer. Farewell.
That was his last sight of her, but he saw it again and again.
Farewell.
Is this a story of love and how it always goes away?
Farewell.
Is this a story of how time can move only in one direction?
Farewell.
Is this a story of the selfishness of love and greed.